Matthew, you just announced Cloudflare for AI this week. It essentially allows customers to safely use and develop AI tech. Up to now, though, what has been the problem? What has been the challenge? What has been the vulnerability?
You know, I think the thing that's really hard in the AI space is, as your last segment was talking about, is everyone's just rushing as fast as possible. Everyone's bored of saying, what are we doing in AI? And everyone is trying to go as fast as possible. And what that means is mistakes get made. Data that shouldn't leave your enterprise gets sucked up into an AI model. People maybe are using AI in a way which might embarrass you or your firm. And what we've heard from our customers is that they want guardrails. They want controls to be able to make sure that even as they go as fast as possible, they're not going to break anything, which is really, really important. And so that's what we're launching with Cloudflare for AI. And we're really excited to see already customers using it to make sure they can go as fast as possible, but not make those critical mistakes in the space of AI.
Matthew, you've got so many current security offerings already when you think about web applications, firewall, observability, API protection. What's new here in terms of Cloudflare for AI? Is it a new bundling thematic, or is there really new offerings coming?
You know, I think that it is a combination of building on the foundation that we have, where we can process just vast amounts of data flowing through our systems, do analysis, do all those controls, but then adding on top of it, not just how are we looking for hackers, how are we looking for threats, but how are we actually looking for the ways that people might be using AI in a way that might be embarrassing to a company, in a way that might be revealing secrets that are there. And I think part of what's powerful here is, yes, we have a whole bunch of customers that care about keeping their use of AI secure, but a lot of the AI companies, in fact, most of the major AI companies also use Cloudflare. So we've been able to actually integrate those two sides in a way that give you a holistic offering and make sure that you can, again, go as fast as possible with AI, but do it in a way which is secure and has real guardrails.
That speed, that desire to get out in front when it comes to AI, many would class that as hype. Can you just set the broader context here of whether you think the AI hype is turning into AI productivity reality?
Yeah, you know, I think there's in any time you have something which is as disruptive a new technology as AI, there are going to be a certain amount of money which is spent on it, which is just lit on fire. And I think that's just the reality that's there. But what we're seeing is that there's real value which is being created as well. And so even if we assume that only 1% of what's being done today turns into value, what we see from our customers, what we see from the AI companies that are out there, is that 1% has the opportunity to have enormous returns. And so, again, I think anyone who's not doing at least something experimenting in AI is probably missing the boat here. And again, I don't hear a lot of customers that are saying, gosh, we're going to, you know, shut down our AI efforts. Instead, I think people are stepping on the accelerator, finding more ways to use this. And again, I think we have to acknowledge some of this is going to be just lighting money on fire, but a lot of it is going to turn into real innovation over the long term.
Matthew, investors watching right now probably are wondering, how big of a business does this turn into for Cloudflare? What are you modeling internally?
So we don't forecast anything in particular, but what I will say is customers are coming to us, and this was a real demand that was driven by our customers saying, you are extremely well positioned to be able to solve this problem. This is something that we want and that we want you to build. And so I think that gives us a lot of confidence that as we invest in this space, that it's something where there will be real returns. It's something that customers want. It's something that the largest enterprises are realizing that they need, that they can't just go at the, you know, full throttle without those guardrails in place. And because of the unique position that Cloudflare is in, we can deliver those guardrails and make sure that you can use AI safely.
Because you're offering the platform to build, to deploy the apps, you're also offering the security. But paint the picture of the ecosystem right now, because people might be thinking, okay, your competitors are like AWS and Fastly, but then there's this deal with Google buying Wiz and what that does for overall security of infrastructure, cloud infrastructure. Where do you fit in with Cloudflare, Matthew?
I mean, those are all very different companies. And I think the first thing to say is congratulations to the Wiz team. It's incredibly hard to build companies. And the fact that they so quickly built something that had enormous value and were able to sell it to Google, I think is something that, again, deserves an incredible amount of, you know, tip of the hat to them and what they're doing. I think the fact that Google had to build Wiz just shows how security has to be part of any cloud platform. And Cloudflare really started with security. And I think that's given us a huge advantage over time. Wiz is really great at identifying what an enterprise's security vulnerabilities are. And what we're proud of at Cloudflare is that we have actually been the solution, once Wiz had identified the problem, to actually solving the security problem behind the scenes, where they're recommending us as that solution. Google's been a long-term partner of Cloudflare. We hope that will continue. I expect that will continue over time. And I think integrating Wiz actually makes it make more sense for them to be integrating closely with Cloudflare and being able to deliver our services as one seamless offering.